tonight, since we have spent a lot of time on this particular newscast examining this talk about the, you know, militarization of outer space, Chinese, Russians, the U.S., I thought you'd want to know about a new breakthrough that might allow some spacecraft to travel without fuel or any type of energy source. Think about that, right? Something that's able to move without being pushed or without being fueled. Or solar, or any of that stuff, right? So how's that possible? Well, there are scientists in California who've come up with a new form of movement that involves, are you ready? You remember when you were a kid, you used to watch the magicians on TV? They used to do what?
Levitate.
Levitation, exactly. Here's Michelle Greenstein to tell us about it. Are they serious? Is this real?
Yeah, I mean, if we're taking them at their word, yes, these scientists at Caltech have essentially discovered a way to propel and levitate objects using light and light only. It's said that this work, as you kind of alluded to, is a step towards developing spacecrafts that could actually leave our solar system, reach planets outside of our solar system. But light's been used to manipulate objects before, but until now you needed a very intense, highly focused laser beams. So we could only do this with very small objects at short distances because, of course, there was limitations on the material, the size, the shape of the objects that you could levitate. But with this new research, objects of many different sizes and shapes could be manipulated with just a light beam. So, you know, levitation, it's not just for nanoparticles anymore.
It's not like your grandfather's Cadillac anymore. So you're saying real levitation, like things actually, I mean, we're not kidding here. They actually will be able to move, keep things and move
at
them.
At a macro scale, yeah.
And it's not new, but
The levitation itself is not new, but the fact that it could be for things, like I said, bigger than nanoparticles is new. Now, the way they do this is by creating these nanoscale patterns on the surface of the object. So this kind of patterning interacts with the light in a way that the object can right itself if it's thrown off. So we don't need these highly focused laser beams anymore, which, like I said, means we can levitate bigger and bigger objects.
This may sound silly, but I'm thinking about all those movies, and I'm a little older than you, but we used to watch all these science fiction movies where we'd see all these, you know, spaceships move, but without leaving tracks or without anything. It's almost like somewhere, sometime, somebody will come up with a new kind of technology that will allow propulsion without any movement or any fuel. Is that what they're thinking they could do?
Yes, in essence, yes. They're saying we could maybe have spacecraft that are being accelerated by laser beams here on Earth that wouldn't need to carry fuel and actually could travel to stars at a very, very high speed. But let's take a listen to it from the horse's mouth. Here's how Professor Atwater explained it. He is the professor of applied physics at Caltech. There's an audaciously interesting, is it audaciously? I've never heard that word before. Audaciously,
yeah.
Thank you. Interesting application to use this technique as a means for propulsion of a new generation of spacecraft. We're a long way from actually doing that, but we are in the process of testing out the principles. But actually, what I found out, Rick, today...
By the way, he does not look like a horse.
No,
I kid.
He doesn't.
But I do want to return... I do want to return... Well, you said right from the horse's mouth.
Oh!
I do want to return to something, though. Is this funded by the Air Force?
It is, yes.
Oh, what a surprise.
Funded by the Air Force's science branch. And actually, you and I reported on the Air Force getting a new space arm last week, so this is probably in connection with that. But this levitation and the government funding levitation science actually isn't new. Let's take a look at this unclassified rundown of DARPA accomplishments, what they say they've accomplished in the fiscal year of 2008. They actually say that they've developed levitation methods. There it is right there, right above fluid contortion sensing, which your guess is as good as mine. But another thing DARPA's working on, which I got to mention because while digging into their website, I thought this was absolutely wild,
right,
is that they're developing something called smart dust, which means that undetectable particles in the air are soon going to be recording everything wirelessly. They say that they've had this technology since at least 2016. Well, it definitely exists. So the question is it out there?
Before you go, would you just tell our viewers what DARPA is, just so they know?
Sure. So DARPA is actually a branch of the Pentagon. It's the Defense Advanced Research Projects Agency, and it basically they fund a million different things with the assumption that like 1 or 2% of the things are going to work
out. Defense Advanced Research Project Industry.
Yeah, they actually are behind the internet, the creation of the internet as well.
Thank you.
Sure.
I'm Rick Sanchez. You found us on YouTube, and that's awesome. But you know what? I'm also live every night at 7 and 8 p.m. Eastern on Direct.